If you believe the hype, in 5 years' time, you'll probably be watching this on a 3D printed telly, sitting on your 3D printed sofa, drinking a 3D printed cup of tea. I'll probably be 3D printed too.
But it's undeniable that in the last few years, 3D printing has exploded. And it's not just architects, designers, and other creative sorts that are getting their cravats in a twist about the technology that some people even have in their homes. For the uninitiated, 3D printing is the process of creating a three-dimensional solid object from a digital model. Normally, if you wanted to make something out of stone, for example, you'd start with a big block and hack away at it. 3D printing starts with nothing and adds material layer by layer to create the exact shape you want. Using this process, you can create nearly anything, from bits of space rockets to, well, Christmas ornaments. We've got three 3D printers to put to the test to do exactly that. The laser-cut Ultimaker Original instantly betrays its maker community roots. Its design may not be to everyone's taste, but it does have a certain backroom chic to it.
It uses a process called fused filament fabrication, which means it very accurately lays down melted plastic layer by layer until the almost always obscure object of your desire appears before your eyes.
Coming in at just under £1,000, it's the cheapest of the printers we're looking at. The Ultimaker is already calibrated before it leaves the factory, but die-hard 3D print fans may want to tinker themselves. 3D printers are operating over tiny, tiny distances, so even a tenth of a millimetre inaccuracy could turn your carefully planned print into a plasticky mess. Once it was set up, we printed our festive test snowman. About 30 minutes later, he emerged, freshly printed and ready to spread festive cheer. The Space Age Form 1 is the slickest looking of our test printers, a huge success on Kickstarter. Technically, it works slightly differently to the other printers. Rather than printing in plastic, this machine uses lasers. The Form 1 shoots a laser, similar to the ones you might find in a Blu-ray player, at a vat of photopolymer resin. Wherever the laser hits, it solidifies into hardened plastic. Do this a few hundred times, and you've got yourself another Christmas tree ornament. It doesn't require any calibration. Once you've plugged it in and downloaded the software onto your computer, you're ready to print. The Form 1's bundled software, Preform, was the best that we tried. Printing our snowman, this time transparent, took much longer though, over 2 hours at 0.5mm resolution. Once it's done, there's a fairly long post-processing stage involving rubber gloves and rubbing alcohol. While the whole process is a lot slower, in our tests it produced smoother looking models with much finer looking details. Coming in at around £2,000, this is the most expensive printer on test.
Like the Ultimaker, the awkwardly named Be The First is another fused filament fabricator. That means it basically melts plastic, not a single laser beam in sight.
The software claims full cross-platform support, but we found that it was a bit clunky and short on options. Once calibrated though, the Be The First was a nice device to use,
producing a perfectly formed, diminutive snowman in 0.1mm resolution.
This is only a small selection of 3D printers that are on the market at the moment. These are definitely enthusiast machines, and you do need to be slightly technical to use them, but I suspect in the not too distant future, devices like these will become much more commonplace.